Hello learners, we have already studied sole proprietorship as a business form, and in this session we are going to learn about partnership form of business organization. We can study the meaning, its features, merits and limitations, and the suitability of partnership form of organization. Partnership. It is an association of two or more persons who pool their financial and managerial resources and agree to carry on a business and share its profit. So, two or more persons join together with an agreement and they pool their money and other resources, including managerial resources, and they will share their profit. If there is loss, they have to share that also in an agreed proportion. Persons who form a partnership, they can be individually called as partners, and persons who form a partnership, we can call them collectively as partnership firm. Let's assume that Gopal is a businessman and he joins hand with Rahim to start a big grocery shop. Here, both Gopal and Rahim are called partners who are running the partnership firm jointly. Both of them will pool their resources and carry on business by applying their expertise. Gopal and Rahim will share the profits and losses in the agreed ratio. In fact, according to the terms and conditions of their working, they will do their business and they will sit together to decide about all the aspects of the terms and conditions. So, they have decided they will start a business in partnership form. So, they have to study the meaning, features and merits. Then only they will decide whether to run this business or not. Partnership form of business organization in India is governed by the Indian Partnership Act of 1932. And it is defined as the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of the business carried on by all or any one of them acting for all. Now let us see the features or characteristics of partnership form. Two or more persons are there to form a partnership. So, to form a partnership firm, minimum two persons are required. Maximum limit is 10 for banking business and 20 for other businesses. If the number exceeds the above limit, the partnership becomes illegal and the relationship among them cannot be called partnership. So, there is a limit, maximum limit as well as minimum limit for each and every form of organization, and for partnership we have 10 in the case of banking business and 20 in the case of other type of partnership business. Second feature, contractual relationship. Partnership is created by an agreement among the persons who have agreed to join hands, and the persons must be competent to enter into contract. So, minors, lunatics and insolvent persons are not eligible to become partners. So, in order to enter into a contract, persons who are eligible can only become partners or can become members of the partnership form of organization. Third feature, sharing of profits and business. There must be an agreement among the partners to share the profits of the business of the partnership firm. And similarly, there must be an agreement to share the losses of the business of the partnership firm of organization. Another feature, existence of lawful business. Business of which the persons have agreed to share the profit must be lawful. It must be agreeable in the eye of law. Any agreement to indulge in smuggling, black marketing, etc. cannot be called partnership business in the eye of law. Another feature, principal and agent relationship. There must be an agency relationship between partners. Every partner will be acting as a principal as well as agent of the partnership firm. When a partner deals with other partners or he will act on behalf of other partners, then such a partner is known as the agent of other partners. And the other partners at this point of time will be the principal. So, the person who is acting on behalf of other partners will be the agent and all other remaining partners will be the principal. Another feature, unlimited liability. In sole proprietorship also, we have shared this as a feature, unlimited liability. So, you got the meaning and same feature we have in partnership. Partners of a firm have unlimited liability. And they are jointly as well as individually liable for the debts of the firm. That is, if there are A, B and C as three partners, A, B and C are jointly liable for the debts. And if B and C are unable to pay the debts, then individually A has to clear the debts of the business. So, jointly and individually liable for the debts of the firm. If the assets are insufficient to meet the firm's liability, then the personal properties of the partners are utilized for clearing the debts. So, that is known as unlimited liability. Liability is not limited to the properties of the partnership firm. But it is extended to the personal properties of the partners to clear the debts. Another feature, voluntary registration. Registration of a partnership firm is not compulsory. But always if there is a document as a proof that will help every organization, same is the case with partnership. An unregistered firm suffers from some limitations which makes it compulsory to be registered. Unregistered firm suffers from the limitations like the firm cannot sue outsiders, although the outsiders can sue the firm. In case of any dispute among the partners, unregistered firm is not possible to settle the dispute through court of law. Unregistered firm cannot claim adjustments for amount payable to partners or amount receivable from any other party. Now, we should identify the merits of partnership because Rahim and Gopal are trying to form a partnership business, so they should identify the merits of this form of organization. Then only they can decide whether to start the partnership business or not. So, as a first merit, partnership business is so easy to form. A partnership can be formed easily without many legal formalities. And it is not compulsory to get the firm registered. So, oral agreement with that a partnership firm can be started. and if the partners decide, written agreement is needed and thereby a partnership firm can be started. Another merit, availability of large resources. You have studied sole proprietorship form of organization. There only one person's money and resources are utilized to run the business. Since two or more partners join hands to form partnership firm, it may be possible to pool more resources when we are comparing with the sole proprietorship form of business organization. Another merit, better decisions. In partnership firm, each partner has a right to take part in the management of the business. All major decisions are taken in consultation with the consent of all the partners. Thus, collective wisdom prevails and there is less scope for unfair decisions. Partnership firm is a flexible form of organization because at any time the partners can decide to change the size of the organization. Similarly, partners can decide the nature of the business or change the nature of the business at any point of time. Area of operation can be expanded. But all these changes can be made only with the consent of all the partners. So it is so flexible form of organization. Sharing of risk as a merit of partnership form of organization. The losses of the firm are shared by all the partners equally as per the agreed ratio. So, risk is spreading to all the partners so that it will not be a burden of only one partner. So, this form of organization is better than the sole proprietorship form of organization. Keen interest as a merit of partnership. Since partners share the profits and losses equally or at an agreed ratio, they take keen interest in the affairs of the business. They are more vigilant in the affairs of the business because if there is any loss, every partner should bear the loss. Benefits of specialization as a merit of partnership. All partners actively participate in the business according to their specialization and knowledge in any particular field. In a partnership firm, providing legal consultancy to people, one partner may deal with civil case, another partner will engage in criminal case, another partner will engage in labor case. So, according to their area of specialization, each and every partner of this firm is engaged. This is a legal firm, so each partner is specialized in particular field and they are engaged in that field. That is, specialization is possible in the partnership form of organization and its benefit can be achieved by this form of organization. Protection of interest as a merit of partnership. In partnership form of business organization, the rights of each partner are fully protected. Similarly, interest of each partner are fully protected. It is possible to maintain secret in partnership business. Business secrets of the firm are only known to partners. It is not required to disclose any information to the outsiders. It is not compulsory to publish the annual accounts of the firm. So, secret of the business will be with the partners only. Having learned about the nature and merits of partnership firm, of business organization. Now, Gopal has decided to expand his business by starting a partnership form of business. One day, in a happy mood, he met Rahim, who also runs a grocery shop in the same locality, and explained to Rahim about the concept of partnership form of organization, its features and merits. Rahim heard Gopal very carefully and asked Gopal about the limitations, if there is any limitation of this form of organization or not. Gopal had no idea about its limitation. Let him now have an idea about the limitation of partnership form of business organization. As a limitation, we would like to have unlimited liability. We have already studied it as a feature. So you should say from your point, which is that limitation, unlimited liability. The most important drawback of partnership firm is that the liability of the partners is unlimited. It means the partners are personally liable for the debt and obligations of the firm. Their personal property can be utilized for the payment of firm's liabilities. Another limitation of partnership, instability. Every partnership firm has uncertain life. The death of a partner brings the firm to an end. Insolvency of any partner brings the firm to an end. Incapacity of any partner, that his health is not good, then that also brings the firm to an end. Sometimes retirement of any partner also brings the firm to an end. So, partnership form of organization has instability, that is, it is a limitation of this form. Limited capital, because when compared with the company form of organization, maximum number of persons to form a partnership is very limited. The total number of partners cannot exceed 20. The capacity to raise funds also will remain limited. So, when compared with joint stock company, partnership firm will not be able to raise more capital. Non-transferability of share as a limitation of partnership. The share of interest of any partner cannot be transferred to other partners or to the outsiders. So, it creates inconvenience for the partner who wants to transfer his share to others fully or partly. The alternative is dissolution of the firm. If there are two or more persons engaging in a business, there is possibility of conflict. So, this can be a limitation of partnership firm also. In partnership firm, every partner has equal right to participate in the management. Also, every partner can place his opinion before the management regarding any matter at any time. Because of this, sometimes there is quarrel among the partners, disagreement among the partners. Now, coming to different types of partners. According to the extent of participation, we can have mainly two types of partners, active partners and sleeping partners. The partners who actively participate in the day-to-day operations of the business are active partners or working partners. Partners who do not participate in the day-to-day activities of the business are sleeping partners or dormant partners. On the basis of sharing of profits, we can have nominal partners and partners in profits. Nominal partners allow the firm to use their name as partner. They neither invest any capital nor participate in the day-to-day operations. As they do not invest capital, they are not entitled to the share of profits of the firm. But they are liable to the third parties for the acts of the firm. Partner in profits, a person who share the profits of the business without being liable for the losses are partners in profits. That partner will enjoy only the profits. He will not be liable for any losses of the firm. This is the case with minor as a partner. On the basis of liability, we can have limited partners and general partners. Liability of limited partners is limited to the extent of their capital contribution. This type of partnership is found in European countries and in USA. This is limited partners. The partners having unlimited liability are general partners. On the basis of the behavior, we can have partner by estoppel and partner by holding out. If a partner declares that a particular person is a partner of their firm and such a person does not disclaim it, one partner of a partnership business declares another person as a partner of their firm and that another person is not disagreeing with that, then he is known as partner by holding out. A person who behaves in the public in such a way as to give an impression that he is a partner of the firm, then such a partner is called partner by estoppel. Such partners are not entitled to the share of profits of the firm. As they have not invested, they are not entitled to the profits of the firm. But as he is behaving in a way that he is a partner of this particular firm, he is fully liable if somebody suffers because of his false representation. Now, going to the suitability of partnership form of organization. Persons having different ability, skill or expertise can join hands to form a partnership firm to carry on the business. Partnership activities like construction, providing legal services, providing medical services, etc. can be successfully run under partnership form of business organization. Partnership form of business organization is suitable where capital requirement is of a medium size. And businesses like wholesale trade, professional services and small manufacturing units can be successfully run by partnership firms. Dear learners, in this session you have learned meaning of partnership, its characteristics, merits and limitations. At last, we have identified the suitability of partnership form of business organization. Thank you.
हिंदुस्तान के हर कोने में नौजवानों के पास प्रतिभा है, उन्हें अवसर चाहिए.
NIOS has been providing opportunities to youth for their development. Some of them have brought great laurels to the institute. With NIOS, many Divyang students have proved their strength. Join NIOS and make a difference.
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत. NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी. शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें, अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं: क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रीयकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से, जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।
जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने, हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने, हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने। कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय के